morning, students. Till now, we have studied the fundamental concepts of the pointers, how to use the pointers, how the pointer is represented in memory, the simple pointer programs in which how to declare, how to assign the address, and how to dereference the pointer, what are the various nulls associated with the pointers, how arithmetically we can manipulate the pointers. And now we'll start using the pointers similar to last time we have seen it, the pointers to the array. Now in this we are going to study in more detail today, pointer to structure in more detail. But whenever the pointers to the structures, pointer to the array, pointer to any different data type, we need to understand that when we develop the C programming, we write many functions. We pass the parameter to the functions. Function returns the value. So here we can have a question, can any function, when we write it, we declare it, function can return the pointer to type? Can one function can return something which is referencing where caller calls that function and caller is passing the parameter? So caller and callee can share the memory space. Can caller pass a pointer as a parameter? Can whatever the callee is returning to me, can it return a pointer? And at that address, whatever he has changed, can I access it? So first of all, example, let's we study that returning a pointer here. That means we need to study that any of the function which we write it, which returns a type of pointer, that here we call returning a pointer. Now into that, let we declare a one of the basically a function called create array, which is accepting a value integer, which is returning a value double star. That means create array function is returning a sum pointer variable which is pointing to the double, or we can say double star means pointer to double. That means create array is returning a pointer to double variable's value, or we can say it is returning a pointer to the double type. Within a create array, whatever the return statement which we write, along with the return, either I should an expression returning the pointer to double, or it should return any variable which should match with the correct type double star. So here what we are doing here in this create array function, normally C programming language contains a many of the header files. Header file contains a declaration of variables, constants, macros, and many other things. The same way, whenever we compile the program and then link the program, that library contains, while we are linking, a many of the functionality. All these function calls are readily available. And mostly, whenever we do dynamic memory programming, at that time, earlier, you might have studied, or you may study a group of function calls, which is malloc, calloc, and alloc, which are nothing else for allocation of the memory. Malloc is one such memory management related function, which is basically accepting a parameter based on to the multiplied with a correct type of the variable value. And that correct group of the variable values, it allocates a memory, whatever the region which we want. And that memory region is pointed by some variable, and that variable value is returned to you. As we know, that memory contains a group of 8 bytes, that means it can be pointed by pointer to the integer only, or it should be a array of integer only. So here we want that if I want to call create array with 1000 value, that means I want a 1000 block of the double variables in a memory, and I want a pointer pointing to that block. That means if I call create array with 100, means I want a 100 values of a double in a memory, and that 100 values of double in a memory block which is pointed by some variable, and that variable pointer I want it to be written by the create array. That means here we are doing malloc within that bracket, sz is a size variable multiplied by size of double. That means if sz is equal to 100, 100 doubles SZ is equal to 1000 means 1000 double. That means malloc is accepting what the number of basic element you want and the size of that basic element multiplied by that much memory it is allocated. That is why malloc is memory allocation. But malloc is not returning me that block directly. Malloc is returning me, if you see the basically instruction of the malloc help anywhere, wherever you find in Google or somewhere, if you see the return type of malloc will be always a pointer pointing to the void. That means malloc can return any point type. That means malloc return is returning to the void onto the left hand side. We can have any pointer pointing to type. That is why we are having a onto the left hand side double, then star and P. That means P is pointing to the double and P equal to the whole size of double type. But if you are returning a block of integer type and left hand side is a double, you need to do the right type casting. Here we are asking for the block of double values, and on left hand side P is pointing to the double. That is why you do not need any type cast. That is why double star P equal to malloc of a SZ times the number of double variables. So here we can say that P is pointing to the block of double values. And now we want to check it. Is there memory allocated to me? If it is allocated, P is pointing to something which is not a null. P is pointing not a zero, but is pointing to some valid double values. That is why within that we are checking by using a if within a bracket, P not equal to null here. You can check P not equal to zero also, but P not equal to small n, small u, small l. That means it will try to compare with the character constant. So here P can be compared with address zero, or P can be compared with a capital N U double L. That means P not equal to null. That means if P is not zero, it will go inside into the loop and it will print IDX equal to zero till IDX less than SZ and then IDX plus plus, and we are in this. That means what we are doing in this create array function, we are declaring a array of double. We are initializing each of the array element with a 0, 0. If you want each of the array element 99, then you write P of index IDX equal to in place of 0.0 and 99. That means we are within a loop, for loop, if P is not null, initializing all of the double element. You can say I can do the initialization of all by declaring array, but that array, if you declare of 50, it will be 50 size. That array is of 100 size, but not dynamically available. Here create array function, we are writing whatever the value you pass it, that much size of the double array is given to you, and to that array we are pointing to the P and we are returning a P. That means create array is returning a pointer. That is why this is a returning pointer function, which we say. That means we can say any function can return any pointer type, only the right syntactic declaration you should do it. The same way within a create array, I can have int SZ and then I can have another array, and within that array I can pass a pointer to that. That means we have taken example that function can return a pointer, but pointer can be passed into the function also, right? We'll see pointer to functions and pointer to structure, many other example later on, that when we write a function we can pass a pointer also. So here this is a function returning a pointer. Now let's say while we are declaring any function which is returning a pointer, we should always take care about, are we returning a right pointer? Are we returning a right address? Are we returning a valid address? That means within a function f, let's see in this slide, we are declaring one of the local variable. Within a local variable, we are calling a predefined a rand function which is returning some integer between 0 to 1. Let's say it is 0.35. So 0.35 multiplied by 1000 and then take that remainder, and we say that 35 it returns. That means whenever rand function and modulus 1000 we take it, it returns me whatever the rand function we value that multiplied by the 1000. That means if it is returning 35, that means 0 to 35 value it will be there. So here we can say local will have, if 0.35 by rand, then local will have a 35. That means now local variable containing 35 is there. Now I want to say, if I declare a one of the pointer variable, and can I point to that local variable? So int star p equal to f star is the right declaration, because f and then bracket, we are calling function within function, recursive function. So that p is pointing to. But at the last, if we see it, it is return, then ampersand, and then local. We say declaration is correct. Int star, that means should return a pointer to integer. We are returning a right value, because ampersand of local, local is int variable, and address of int variable we are printing. Type matching is there. Syntactically correct, logically correct. But does it return a right pointer? Does it return a right pointer here means, after the function is called, function gets started, executed from the first statement. Function is finished. One variable which is declared within a function is a local variable. One function is called and finished. And when you go back to the caller from Kohli, that local variable is not available. If that local variable is not available, that return value, that pointer pointing to the variable which has been already been destroyed, variable has been already died, variable which has been already killed, can we have that address of that died variable meaningful to us? That means whatever the pointers which we are declaring is right, but whatever the return value which we are doing, that's a pointer, is a bad pointer. That means the pointer points to something and that something has died is a bad pointer. That means pointer anytime point to something, either it should be a null pointer or it should point to a valid variable memory location, but it should not point to something which is not there, which does not exist. So anything which does not exist, address of that, if we pointer is pointing, is called bad pointer. So bad pointer is different from null pointer. Null pointer is definitely pointing to zero, but bad pointer is pointing to something which does not exist. That means bad pointer creates many times many dangling pointers, wild pointer, which can give a panic error. So whenever the any program which runs, and many times if you run the program, you have a core dump. Core dump is a very, very typical error which is faced by the student when they do not use pointer rightly. That time you can say such kind of a bad pointer usage is there. That means it is always very, very much important when you are debugging your program. See, anytime you are returning a pointer, at that time you should know that does that pointer, whatever it's returning, that pointer is pointing to target, that target does exist. If target exists, an address of the target is a value of pointer, then it's good pointer. If target does not exist, then address of that non-existence value is a bad pointer. So it is very important, bad pointers, while pointer, dangling pointer, null pointer are basically a critical reason for giving a such core dump or panic errors. Now here we see a constant pointer. Let's see what is a constant pointer. Whenever we say that array variable is declared, it's a array or a group or collection of many values in a memory, the fixed size of that collection, fixed size of that group. So here int arr array, that's array variable of a 20 integer values. That means in a memory, we can say 40 bytes are reserved, and every group of 2 bytes is a one array element. That means 20 element, 40 bytes, and the first element address is array, which is array variable. Now second we declare int star p. So p can also point to a group of many integers, as we know that p is pointing to the first element, then p can be incremented, then again p can be incremented. That means p itself can point from the first assigned value till go on incrementing. That means p can be treated as an array. Now whenever we write p equal to array, it means array is a group of 20 values. P can point to group of integer value. That means p equal to array is a syntactically, logically, and the at the runtime, p can point to correct 20 different values. That means p equal to array is a logically correct assignment statement. But p equal to array is allowed. But air is equal to P is not allowed. Into the comment in a blue color, by mistake I have written it P equal to ampersand air, which is a correct value. But air equal to P is not allowed. But P equal to ampersand air again is invalid. That is why we can say P is equal to ampersand of some variable value is valid. P is equal to ampersand of array variable is also allowed. But here array itself is a pointer, that is why ampersand of air is invalid. So you can say it's not by mistake, but it's correct, right? So we can say P is equal to address of array is not allowed, P is equal to address of integer value is allowed. So P is equal to air is right, but P is equal to ampersand air is invalid. Now let's say we try to access all of the element of the array by using a array syntax, that is a for loop, for I equal to 0, I less than 20, I plus plus, and printf percentage d and air of I. That means for every value of I 0 to 20, it will print 20 different values of the array. Same thing can we do using a pointer. As we know that P is pointing to the air in earlier is a discrete, but without using that statement, if you want to write only for loop, let's do this initialization P equal to array into the for loop. So P equal to array is initialization, then semicolon, then we are checking P is not equal to null. That means you go on incrementing P, that means within array it is advancing array element, and then we are saying P plus plus, that is a advancement, and P not equal to null is a check of the last element of the array, and we are printing percentage d. And if we write a P, then it will be wrong, but we want to say wherever P is pointing, that value you give it to me. That is why we are writing star P. So for loop with a P initialized to array, checking for every iteration P is not equal to null, and for every iteration we go on incrementing the P plus plus, and we are printing at P. That means wherever P is pointing, print that value. That means we are printing the same as all of the array element, 20 element. But at the bottom, if you see it, A double R equal to P is not allowed. Why? We know that array is of fixed 20 size, while P can point to 20, 30, 40, 1000, any of the integer element group. We know that P can point to anywhere into the memory. That means value of the P, that's the address of any variable, address of any integer is allowed. But air is an array variables. Within an air, whatever address is available, that is only of those 20 element. That means air can contain 20 values, but the address of air, wherever the 20 elements are there, that is a fix. That means address of the air variable is fixed. That is why air is a type of integer array, is called constant pointer. That means variable value can point to constant, but constant cannot point to another variable value. That means P equal to air is valid assignment statement, but air equal to P is not valid, because on right hand side RVL is a variable, on left hand side air is a constant. That means array is constant pointer whose address cannot be changed. That means constant equal variable is not allowed, as we know that RVL is always a variable values or expression. LVL is always a value wherever the value can be changed. So here within that we can just conclude that array is always a pointer, but it is a constant pointer. Now let's see in this slide, there are a four different type of declaration. Here we see that int star P, as all of you know, that P is a pointer, target is an integer data, and P is pointing to that target integer data, and within that statement P plus plus, if I do it, pointer will advance, but at star P plus plus I do it, that means wherever P is pointing to, that target data can be changed. That means pointer and target both can be changed. But if I write constant, that's a C-O-N-S-T, int star P, that means we can say that const is not a word before the P, means pointer can be changed, but whatever pointer is pointing to, pointer P's type is const int star, that means target cannot be changed. That means pointer is pointing to const int star, that means at P one time value is allowed, but after that cannot be changed. That means pointer is a variable, But whatever that pointer is pointing to the target value is not a variable, that is a constant. So here we can say, earlier as already told you, that pointer can point to variable also, and pointer can be point to the constant also. So this is a pointer pointing to the constant integer. Third declaration, if you see, int star const p. So here we can say p is a pointer which is pointing to int star. That means p can point to any of the integer data. That means p can contain the address of the integer data. That's what the meaning. But just writing a const before p, that means value of p cannot be changed. That means once p is assigned a one address, that address cannot be changed. That means we can say here target can be changed, but pointer cannot be. That means p plus plus not allowed, p equal to p plus 1 not allowed, p is equal to p minus 1 not allowed, p minus minus not allowed, minus minus p is not allowed. That means p's value cannot be changed. That is why we can say pointer is a constant pointer similar to the earlier the array. That means int star const p, if you do, you can say it is a nothing else but constant pointer based array by using a pointer. Now fourth declaration, if you see, const is a prefix before int star also, const is a prefix before p also. That means the target cannot be changed, pointer cannot be changed. That means we can say this is one of the one-time pointer declaration which can never be advanced, and whatever a pointer value it is pointing to the int is the constant. That means here we can say indirect reference which we are doing, which is becoming a one-time singleton declaration. So this kind of declaration is many times used by a libraries, wherever we can say that one of the indirect reference to some constant, like I want a pointer to some pi variable. I want, there is a pi, there is epsilon, there are many, all those values are there, and that is a collection of some table is there, and that table also at a fixed memory location, I want it one time. Then that type of a table containing many values and all values are a fix, and that table wherever it is located in a memory is all fixed, then this fourth declaration can be used. So here we can say that constant pointer, pointer pointing to the target constant, pointer pointing to the value where pointer is a constant, or pointer pointing is pointing to the target is a constant, or both are constant. So that is a constant keyword wherever we use is very much important, where I should keep it in my declaration. Now, earlier I told you that there is a null pointer, there is a bad pointer, there is a good pointer, and we know now void pointer is what. That means if I say void star and p, that means we can say p is a pointer, number one. Second is we say pointer pointing to the type. What type? As we know by earlier lessons given by all other teachers, that void is one of the data type. And whenever we say here void means any type, it means p can point to integer also, later in future. P can point to long also, later in future. That means if I want to declare a one of the address variable, I want to declare a one of the pointer variable, I want to declare a one of the reference variable which can refer to any other type, which keeps on changing other type, which can contain the address of any other type, which can contain the address of any data type in memory, that means I should declare a pointer pointing to the void, and such kind of a pointer is called void pointer. Void pointers are not useful in many situations, many times we see, but we have already made use of one of the malloc function. Malloc can return a 100 doubles, malloc can return 100 integer, malloc can return 100 student structure type, malloc can return 100 employee type, malloc can return 100 node, where node can be the any type. That means malloc return type is not known what user or a programmer is going to use for. That is why the return type of a malloc is a void star. So it is very, very useful when many of the system functions are available within the library. Most of the time the user or a programmer is developing application, that time we know that he doesn't know what type to point. At that time he can use a void pointer. So it is very much important that whenever the general return type is there, general function we want to call, general data block we want to use, such kind of programming is called generic programming, within this generic programming, the data structure which we are going to use it keeps on changing. So generic data structures are there. That means templates are there. So such kind of templates, generic data structures, generic programming, void star is very important, or we can say void pointer is very important. So many of the situations students say that, sir, I never use void pointer. But if you want to do generic programming, if you do not know the right type it is going to return, in that case, void pointer, you can use it. Now, let's say the last topic of the 2 days, part three, which we are studying together, in which the most important is, if we declare a structure variable, and if we declare a pointer, and someone can ask, can pointer variable can contain the address wherever my structure variable is stored in memory? So wherever the structure variable you declare it, and wherever the pointer you declare it, and you want that pointer variable should contain the address of structure, we need to declare pointer to the structure. So structure using pointer, in which we are going to study the right declaration of the structure variable, right declaration of the pointer containing the address of structure variable. But before we do that declaration, let's understand one of the C program, in which how do we access the data of structure by using a normal structure variable without using a pointer, and then using a pointer variable. As we know it, you must have studied a structure earlier, in which whenever we are declaring a structure, it's a group of another different data types. So within that group, whatever the structure variable we want to access, that means the structure variable or that group variable name, and then dot, and that member variable. That means group contains a three member. That means group one dot member one is the member one of the group variable. Group one dot member two is the member two of that group variable. So we know that dot is a operator which is called structure operator. That means that is used to access the member of the structure. Now we will study whenever we use pointer along with the structure, another operator, that is called arrow. So in the next slide, let's go that how we copy one structure variable to another structure variable in a many different ways. So here we are having one of the structure program in which we will declare the structure variable, and we declare another structure variable, and we try to copy one structure variable to another structure variable, or simply we say copy one structure to another structure in C. This we can do using three different methods. One, we copy the structure 1 to structure 2 directly, if both the type, while we are writing assignment statement, onto the right hand side structure variable and left hand side structure variable are of similar type. That is, we copy using direct assignment of a structure to another structure. Or we use one inbuilt memcpy1 function is available. Normally, string.h file, you must have studied it, where various string functions are there, strlen, strcat, strcpy, etc. The same way, if you are going to use only string to string copy, string functions are there. But if you are going to have one of the block containing memory, containing an array of characters, that is a string, and that size is not none, that means same string copy can be done by memcpy. So there are some memory operation related memory functions into the same string.h file, which are a memcpy, meminit, memcat. Such of the memory operations are there. One of the memcpy function will use, using the memcpy along with the pointer, we can copy structure 1 to structure 2. And another one is, we can member by member copy, we can do it. That means we understand the pointer to structure, structure variable, usage of pointer along with the structure, and we copy one structure to another structure in three different ways. So within this one program, we are going to have four part. We will declare a structure variable, we will declare a pointer which can contain a valid address of the structure variable, and we write a three program blocks for copying a three different ways. So within this one program structure, let's make use of the structure, pointer to the structure, and three methods. So these three, what we have seen it, in which, first of all, pointer to such structure, we are including str.h, string.h, because string.h, we are not directly manipulating the string operations and string function, but we want to use memcpy rather than a strcpy. So mostly whenever the string size is fixed, we use strcpy, but whenever the dynamically unknown memory is known about any string variable, that time memcpy we use it to copy the string. So here we are declaring one of the structure called struct student. You can use type def struct student and then student's type, or we can just use a struct student, and within the struct student we are having a three members. One member is ID, second member is a array, that is a name, a array of 30 character, and third member is a percentage, which is a float type. So whatever the variables which you declare a struct student, S1 or S2 or S3 or record 1 of a struct student type or record 2 of a student type, all this S1, S2, record 1 and record 2, all will contain three members. That means any variable which is a type of struct and tag will become a structure variable. So here student is a structure which we have created which contains a three member. Now let's go into the next slide where we start with int main. Within that we declare a one of the integer variable I. Now we are declaring a one record one variable which is a type of struct student. That means record one dot ID will contain a ID of the student. Record one dot name will contain the name of the student. Record one dot percentage will contain the percent of the students obtained. So here we are declaring a record one, which is type of struct student and having a three initial value, one, Raju, 90.5. That means record one dot ID is having a value one, record one dot name is having a Raju, record one dot percentage is having a 90.5. So we are having a initialize of record one. Now in the second line, we are declaring struct student type of the four variable. Record two is a structure variable. Record 3 is a pointer variable which can point to a struct student. That is why record 3 is a pointer variable pointing to the structure, or we can say record 3 is a pointer to a structure type of variable. Star PTR1. PTR1 is a pointer variable, but it is pointing to what type? It is pointing to struct student. That is why PTR1 is again a structure variable, but it is indirect structure variable. So indirect pointing to the structure means we can say pointer to the structure. Record 4 is a structure variable, but it's not a pointer to structure variable. That means we are having a four variable, record 2 and record 4, structure variable. We are having a other two variable, record 3 and PTR1, are pointing to the structure variable. Now we want to do the three methods. First method, we want to have a copy by copy. So now after having a three declaration, we are printing one statement. Whatever the structure one Raju and 90.5 value, we are printing printf id colon value of record one dot id, name colon value of record one dot name, then percentage, and then we are having a percentage f, that is a record one dot percentage value. That means we have initialized the record one and we are printing the record one. After that, we are starting the three methods. Let's see into the program. So now, first method to copy the whole structure to another structure, record two is equal to record one. Here you should observe that the type of record one is a structure variable, type of record two is a structure variable, both are a structure variable, but both are a similar structure variable, means record one is a struct student, record 2 is a struct student, both are a similar structure variable. We don't need to have any typecasting. We are not missing any value. We are not losing any value. We are syntactically correct assignment. And logically, the value of record 1.id will go into the record 2.id. That means record 1 contains id 1, name Raju, and percentage 90.5. Now record 2 also will contain the same value. That means we are printing. Printf, records of student 2, direct copy from structure to structure. We are printing a id equal to record2.id, name equal to record2.name, and percentage equal to record2.percentage. So that means we are copying it and then printing the value. Now let's go to the second method. Here, as we know, that we have already declared PTR1 is a pointer to structure variables. So PTR1, initially when we declared, it was allocated a memory, but it was not assigned a address. That means PTR1 now is assigned a address. Address of what? Address of record 1. Here we need to check two things always, the students, whenever you do write a program using a pointer to structure. Record 1 is a correct structure variable. PTR1 is a pointer or address variable containing a correct target. So target, record 1 is a structure variable. PTR1, which is pointing to struct student, is a correct target type. That is why we can say PTR1 can contain by using a prefix ampersand as a ampersand of record 1 is a target. That means it is PTR1 is now pointing to the one Raju 90.5, that record variables. Now in a second we want to use a memcpy. If you take a help of memcpy function into your any of the IDE environment, you do it, whether it's an Eclipse, whether it is DevCPP, whether it's a GCC, any, the help manual is available, or you go to Google, that memcpy is going to accept a three parameters. Memcpy is going to return a pointer to a void. So we need to do only three things here, which is very much important, that we want to have a source we want to provide. That copy from where? We know that PTR1 is pointing to the correct record. That means PTR1 is pointing to the struct student type. That means we want to give a size of that record 1. And PTR1, which is already pointing to the record 1, that is our source from where we want to copy the memory block. Where we want to copy to? Okay, we want to copy to into the pointer which we have declared, record 3. Record 3 is pointing somewhere in memory. But initially, record 3, when it was declared as a pointer, it is pointing to nothing. But now record 3 want to have a data from wherever PTR1 is pointing. That means PTR1 is pointing to the memory block containing a all of the value 1 Raju 90.5, which is held by the record 1, which is pointed by the PTR1. That pointer byte by byte is to be copied into the record 3. So here in a memcpy, whenever you use the two pointer variables, you need to observe that PTR1 should point to write pointer type, record 3 should point to write record type. The two observation you need to do, PTR1 and record 3, both are pointer, right? Okay, number one is finished. Now second, you check it, are both of the pointer are pointing to write type? PTR1 is pointing to struct student, record 3 is pointing to struct student, right? That means second is also right. That means first two arguments are right. Now both of these arguments are pointing to whatever the target has we given, the size of that correct target. Yes, PTR1 and record 3, both are pointing to record 1 type. That is where we are giving the size of record 1. That means memcpy is a function in these three which we are using. That means most of the time students, when we are doing the programming, when you study the data structure subject, computer network algorithm subject, scheduling algorithm operating system, in which many of the data structure you are going to use it, that time this type of pointer to structure you are going to use it. But even without that studying that subject, whenever the inbuilt such function you use it, you understand the help of that subject, what are the variables, whenever the pointer to structure is given, always declare that correct pointer type, always give that correct address type, and then pass that parameter. That means using inbuilt function always very, very much important to study the pointer to structure, pointer to function, pointer to array, constant pointer, all these things. Till now we have studied how to declare a pointer, how to assign an address, how to dereference it. But here in this slide, we have studied that we are declaring now structure, and now we are declaring a pointer to structure, and we are just, we can say, assigning address of that. And now here PTR1, we are not dereferencing it, but pointer variable we are passing it. Now memcpy is returning to what? Earlier we have seen it, that memcpy can copy from any type to any type. Then naturally, it must be returning a void star. Whenever it is returning to void star, but now memcpy, whatever is returning that record 3, we want to have into the record variable. That is why we need to have the record 2 variable on left hand side of the memcpy. We need to have correct type casting. So into that correct type casting, whatever it is returning memcpy, that is a copy record, we must type cast within a bracket, that is a struct student and star. So we know that whatever the basically record 3 is a pointer, that is why when we are printing the value, we can write 8 record 3 dot id. 8 record 3 means star record 3 dot id. If you want to have a single operator name of the pointer variable dereference dot is equivalent to arrow. That means star record 3 dot id is equivalent to record 3 arrow and id. So here record 3 arrow id, we are dereferencing the member value of the pointer which is pointing to the structure variable. So now we are printing in a printf statement, printf id, then record 3, then arrow id, then name, the record 3 arrow name, then percentage, the record 3 arrow percentage. That means here we can say this, whatever the small arrow which is visible between the pointer to structure variable and member variable. That means always remember, whenever we have structure variable and member variable are connected by a dot. But whenever pointer to structure, that means pointer variable and arrow variable and pointer pointing to the structure variable are connected by arrow. That means whenever arrow operator between two variable, always remember right hand side towards the arrow is always member of that structure, left hand side is always a pointer pointing to that structure. So here in a second method, not only we have studied that pointer to the structure, how to assign an address of that structure, how to access the members of the pointer pointing to the structure by using arrow operator. So that is why the second, which is doing a copy, not only we have used a inbuilt function of memcpy, but within a memcpy function, whenever we want to pass a pointer to something, pointer to some structure, how to pass it, that also we learn it. That means within a always a complicated or a complex programming, whenever we use the structures and we want to do the dynamic allocation using a many block of the structure, either we need to have a methodology only array of structure. But whenever we do array of structure, we are going to have a limited number of array element. But whenever we manipulate a group of many structure, that means using the pointer, we can have unlimited dynamically at a runtime as many as structure elements we want to use it. That means any simple list of a structure variable you want to do it, list of students or list of employees, always a pointer to structure and pointer pointing to that first element of the structure, or just declare the array of many structures and have a values and iterate by using a pointer. That means pointer to structure is very important in most of the algorithms which you are going to study in future in all of your subjects. Now the third method is only there is a no usage of pointer, but we simply say that there is a record 1 and there is another record 4. Both are a structure variable. We are copying record 1 id assigned to the record 4 dot id by writing a record 4 dot id equal to record 1 dot id. That means member by member we are copying, and then finally record 4 we are printing. So finally, if we execute this program, we are going to have initial student 1, print that initialize student 1, then just we can say that copy structure to structure and print that value, that of record 2, then copy record 3 by using a pointer to structure and print that value, and finally member by member copy, and final output is the same. That means record 1 was the original structure, record 2 was having a structure to structure copy, record 3 was having a memcpy and using a pointer to structure we copied, and record 4 is member by member copy. So in that, not only you have studied a pointer to structure and thus by using a pointer to structure variable in your program, but you also studied that you want to a structure which is collection of many member which is stored in a memory, then how to use a such kind of memory block operations like memcpy similar to the strcpy from string copy to string copy. That is why many times if you any functions you see that anytime pointers are declared, and just always pay attention on to that before the pointer, if there is a constant, or before it is returning a something, a target, a constant, and at that time, whether you use as LVL and RVL is also important. That means not only just pointer is an address variable is important, but what address you are assigning it, after assigning that address, what you are pointing to the target, and how to use such kind of pointer variable just by pointer to structure is many of the three or four different program practice you do it. But after this, just today, we are going to have a pointer to the function also, and many other example also. After this four part of the basic fundamentals and advanced part, we are going to have many examples of pointer which we study during that time. Again, we can say very tricky way and intelligent way of using pointer to structure. We will have one more example later on. So we have studied how to declare a pointer. At that time, declaring a pointer, memory is allocated. We have seen how to assign address to the pointer so that it can become correctly the address variable. Whatever it is pointing, how to get the value of the target by dereferencing the pointer. We know that pointer can point to the address 0, null. That means the right checking of the pointer for null pointer within a if statement condition, within a while loop condition, within a for loop condition is very important. Whenever using the pointer, we traverse many elements. The same way, we also seen that pointer can point to the array, and pointer can be assigned the address of the array, but array can never be assigned with the pointer. Simultaneously, in the part 3 today, we also studied the pointer to the structure, where pointer can point to the structure, pointer can point to the many group of the structure, similar to the pointer can point to the array of many member. The same way, you can have an array of structure, and pointer can point to the array. That means pointer can point to any array, means pointer can point to array of many structure also, and pointer can traverse individual structure element also. And it is very, very much important that whenever we use a pointer, it is always important that pointer, when we use it, whatever the pointer is pointing to the target, all these target values, memory blocks are allocated whenever we assign the address of. That means we can say that using the pointer dynamically, many of the memory blocks we can important. But still, one more very important topic of the pointer, that is the pointer to the function, is remaining. That we are going to study into the next part. But when we are going to complete the basic primitive element operation of all the pointer which you can do, is very important that whenever we are using the pointer, as we have seen it, that pointer can be null, pointer can be the bad, pointer can point to the right data, pointer can point to the group of data, pointer can point to the arrays, pointer can point to the group of the many structure, or pointer can point to the array of structure. Simultaneously, function can return a pointer, function can correctly return a pointer, function can be passed a parameter, within a parameter, primitive data type variable can be passed, pointer to the int can be passed, pointer to the array can be passed, or pointer to the basically, the we can say that structure also can be passed. So after studying into the part 4, pointer to the function, which is very much important for doing a dynamic programming, it is very much important to have many example practice should be done by the student. So what we are going to do that into the next final part of this 4 for understanding the pointer, in a part 4, pointer to functions we understand, then we are going to have a mix example of not only the we have studied a pointers into the in this 4 part, but earlier you have studied, like you must have studied the file, and into the file you must have also studied fopen function. Fopen function is accepting a value, one of the string which is a read and write, also simultaneously name of the file, that's a string. But what is the return value of the fopen? You must have seen it, that capital FILE, which is file, is nothing else, some structure. Is it a structure? Fopen is returning to the pointer. That means we can say it must be a pointer to the structure. That means it is very, very much important, not only inbuilt many of the function examples where we are going to study the basically the internal meaning of how to use a pointer, how the pointers are declared there, and how we have to use it. So into the fourth part, we will study the fundamental of pointer to the function, example of pointer to the function, and then onward using pointer to function, pointer to structure, pointer to array, array and pointers, pointers and struct, pointers and file. We are going to have still after this fourth part, again two examples are there. So it is very, very, very much important, all of the students, that in this first three part, we have studied, that's not an advanced part of the pointer, but it is making use of how to use the pointers in various aspects of all programming element. So it is very, very much important that you be pakka in all pointer declaration, all pointer address assignment, and any type of pointer dereferencing it, and pointer to the such kind of a compound variables like structures, unions, arrays, B also should be very there. But very, very much important that whenever we write a function, at that time it will be very much important. I'm not going to talk about the pointer to function today, but when we talk about that, when we write a function, within the function we are passing a parameter, all these parameters are of pointer types, and whenever the function is returning a pointer which is a pointer type, that is not a pointer to function. That means when we study the function in which we pass the parameter, anything can be a pointer, whatever it written, it can be a pointer. It is not a pointer to function. Pointer to function is a special type of functionality. We'll see that whatever function which you write it, wherever it's stored, and can we point to that code which is stored there? Can we have a library containing hundreds of functions? Can we point there? So that is the beginning I want to initiate today, but we are going to study the pointer to function significance in the next lecture, pointer to function declaration in the next lecture. But before we go to pointer function, till now whatever we have studied in part 1, part 2 and part 3, if you are not conceptually strong, then whatever the first statement in part 1 which I made, that pointers learning is easy. Is it easy if you studied this three part? But if any of these three part, the elementary pointer fundamentals, if you are not very clear, then just for declaring a pointer to function, or array of pointer, where pointer is pointing to function, where function is returning a pointer, such kind of complicated declarations will be very, very difficult. If you have studied any C programming book till now, right, all of the book are going to have a fundamentals of the pointer. But if you have seen the book, which is a C programming by Cunningham and Ricci, he has given a pointer declaration of the many, which is more than a 50, where each one of them is unique. That means, if simply I say that there is a one pointer which is a pointing to the array, where array is going to be a array of many elements, which is going to be again in a pointer, which is a pointer is going to a structure, structure is going to contain a one of the element, which is again a pointer. If such kind of complicated declarations are there, if you are not going to have a basic such kind of fundamental of whatever we have studied in part 1, part 2 and part 3, then it is very difficult to understand a such pointers which you are going to study now in next part. So today is the end. Let's wait for the part 4. By that time you finish your good day.